Hi, welcome to our weekly online preaching. Every week we seek the Lord for the timely revelation in the Word to be released to you. And let us pray first. Father God, we ask for your divine presence. We ask for your divine flow in the Spirit. We ask, Lord God, that you just speak to us and just open our spiritual eyes of understanding, even as we receive the Word of God for this time and season. And all this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. While I was praying and seeking the Lord the other day, I saw a vision. I saw a vision of a powerful torchlight being switched on and shining into a dark, pitch black, completely dark, deep cave. So I was asking the Lord, what does this vision mean? And that's when the Lord says, this is a time to let me search your heart and your soul. For my spirit is like a torchlight that shines through the darkest cave. Look to me, my people, and let me bring light to these areas of your life and bring fresh hope in your life, be it in your past hurts, wounds, shame, or failures. Some of you recently, you have been having dreams. Dreams of certain situation in your past. Dreams of certain not so nice situation in your past. Do not fear, because God is shining the light into that time of your life, into that area of your life, in order to set you free and to restore you and to give you a fresh hope. And I believe that's what it means, the vision. Now I'm bringing you to a Psalm of David, Psalm 139. And I believe this is the time for us to meditate on the whole of Psalm 139. I start from the very end part first of Psalm 139, which is verse 23 and verse 24. It says, search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my anxieties, and see if there's any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. Now, right now, beloved of God, Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God is searching our heart to see if there's any dark area in our soul or in our life. Allow Him. Now, Holy Spirit is like the torchlight that shines into or through the darkest parts in one's life, in our life. Just like shining torchlight in a dark, pitch black, deep cave. And that's exactly what David wrote here, the word search. Now the word search here is kaka in Hebrew. It means to penetrate, like the light penetrating into the darkness, into even your darkest past, darkest wounds, darkest hurts, darkest shame, or even darkest failure. Maybe it was sometime in your teenage years, maybe in your early 20s, or any time in your past. Maybe a certain experience that you would like to let go, but it just kept haunting you again. Maybe for some of you, it was a sexual abuse. Or for others, you have been a victim of terrible bully. Now, God is shining His light. Penetrating, that's word kaka here, to penetrate, hence to examine intimately, to find out, to search out, to seek out, like torchlight that shines into the darkest, the most hidden part of our lives. Why? Because God wants to set us free. God wants to restore us. God wants to give us a fresh new hope going forward. Now, I want to read Psalm 139, verse 23 to 24 from another Bible version, the Expanded Bible. It says here, God, examine, investigate, search me and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there's any bad thing, hurtful way in me. Lead me to everlasting life. So the word search here is not just regarding your past wounds, your past hurts, your past shame, your past failures, and God is setting you free to give you a fresh hope, but it's also about your present spiritual condition or spiritual state of your life. And God is searching that as well. So as you allow the Holy Spirit to search you, even your current situation, current condition of your soul, of your spirit, Some of you, you may even realize, suddenly you have this realization, wow, how can I be so wicked in this area? How can I think such wicked thoughts against so and so? And God is searching like a torchlight, any hidden motives, hidden intentions, or hidden desires, especially fleshly desires that may not be from the Lord. For example, to have more fame, to want to be known by many more people, to have many more followers so you can flaunt it, etc. Now, this applies for some of us, for ministers of God as well. What is your motive when you say you want to have a bigger ministry, a bigger church, bigger stage? Is it because you really want to be a blessing to others, to many lives? Or is it because it feeds your ego? You see, there are many areas in our life that God is in the midst of shining His torchlight into our soul, into our spirit. Why does God want to do that? Because He wants to prepare a greater future for you. So if you may, Psalm 139 is the psalm of now, of this time and season. Meditate on the whole Psalm 139 because it's about God's perfect knowledge of all of us, each of us. Psalm 139, verse 1 to 4. So I'll go right up to the beginning of Psalm 139. Just now was the ending part. Notice this psalm begins and ends with the word search, kaka. It's the same Hebrew word, kaka. Now it says here, O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You understand my thought afar off. You comprehend my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word on my tongue, but behold, O Lord, you know it altogether. In other words, you see, God knows when we sit down, and God knows when we stand up. God knows our thoughts even before we think them. God knows everything we do. Nothing escapes His eyes. Even before we say a word, He already knows it. Why? Because He is omniscient, all-knowing God. And one very interesting thing about this statement, God knows you're sitting down and rising up. You know what it means? It means even such insignificant thing as you taking a seat or standing up at any time of the day, God takes notice. No, it's not to restrict you, but to watch over you. So God has perfect knowledge of you and even your future. Therefore, you know what this means? There's nothing to fear if you have Him, if you have the Lord in your life. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 says, His thoughts for you are thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. So be rest assured, even if the world falls apart, even if the world falls into deep trouble or tribulation, still there's nothing to fear because God knows all and God sees further. God will make a way of escape for you because His thoughts for you are always thoughts of peace, of future, of hope. Amen. So David has this revelation when he wrote Psalm 139. Nothing could escape God's eyes. He acknowledged that. And one thing for sure is David was a worshipper of the Lord, and obviously he has a close and personal relationship with his God. So people of God, it's so important to have a personal relationship with God, to be open to Him, to allow Him to have His way in your life. You see, David knew very well that this God of his, whom he worshipped, isn't just a creator of all things, of heaven and earth, including his own life, but this God cared for him so much so that God searched him, no, not to find faults, to accuse him of wrongdoing, but first and foremost reason is so that God could guide him and lead him into the right ways. David knows God wants the very best for him. So as a beloved of God, David means beloved. You too are the beloved of God. God wants the very best for you. So be like David. You can present your life before the Lord and say, God, search my heart. Show me if there's any area that you want to correct me, change me. And God will surely come in like a torchlight that shines into the cave. And you are blessed because the Lord will begin to guide you, lead you, even the way forward. Amen. But you have to yield to His ways and not be smart in your own eyes. Many people in this world, they think they know better. They are smart in their own eyes. They do not want to acknowledge God. They just want to have their way. In fact, some of them even think that God's ways, God's word, is a hindrance for them to achieve their own ambitions. But I've seen time and again, many people who see it this way, they eventually end up in pitfalls, into trouble. And that's why Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path." And verse 7 says, "Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It will be health to your flesh and strength to your bones." Maybe some of you come to a point when you are at a dead end. You do not know what to do anymore, how to go about with your life anymore. This is the time. Allow the Lord to shine His torchlight into your soul, into your spirit. And I can assure you, God will know how to make a way for you, because your God is not a dead end God. Let me go back to Psalm 139. I continue with verse 7 to verse 10. David said this, "Where can I go from your spirit?" You see, the spirit of God. "Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend into heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell," or actually this word is translated in Hebrew as Sheol, the place for the dead or the grave, "behold, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me." You see, where can we go to get away from His Spirit, the Spirit of God? Nowhere. Neither heaven nor earth. Nowhere. I continue with verse 11 and 12. "If I say, surely the darkness shall fall on me," it means the darkness cover me, "even the night shall be light about me. Indeed, the darkness shall not hide from you, but the night shines as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike to you." So if some people think that darkness could hide or cover them, they are wrong. Because to God, night is as day. Darkness and light are the same to Him, to His eyes. That's how great our God is. The Lord God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth and the whole universe, the whole galaxy. Nothing escaped Him. And because nothing escaped His eyes, nothing escaped Him, therefore there's no injustice that also escaped Him. So maybe you have been a victim of injustice. You have been taken advantage by others before. And you have been shamed before. Or you have been gossiped badly before. Or some people have conspired to work plans against you before. And it seems like they are successful. Take heart, because nothing escaped God's eyes. God knows how to turn things around for you. As long as you keep trusting in Him, be patient, just persevere, and the Lord will see to it that you are going to see breakthrough and you are going to see things being reversed for your life. I continue now, Psalm 139, verse 13 to 14. I'm going to expanded version right now. And this is interesting. "You made, created my whole being, inward parts. You formed, knitted me in my mother's body, belly, womb. I praise, I thank you because you made me in an amazing, awesome, and wonderful way." Yes, indeed. Because, beloved of God, you are you. You are uniquely and specially you. Therefore, never compare with other people. What God you have done is wonderful. I know this very well. I continue with verse 15 to 16. "You saw my bones being formed. My bones were not hidden from you as I took shape in my mother's body. When I was put together, woven together, you, your eyes, saw my body as it was formed, embryo. All the days planned, formed for me were written in your book before I was one day old. Psalm 139, verse 17 to 18 says, God, your thoughts are precious to me. They are so many. How vast are their sum? If I could count them, they would be more than all the grains of sand. When I wake up or come to the end, I am still with you. So whether you wake up from your sleep on earth or you wake up from your sleep when your spirit leaves your body on earth and meet God face to face, God is still with you. So put it this way, if God has that perfect knowledge about you, like what we have learned in Psalm 139, there's nothing that we fear. There's nothing that we need to fear. Of whom shall we fear? Of whom shall we be afraid of? And I want to bring you all the way back to the beginning in the book of Genesis, how God's light shines as a cross-reference. Genesis 1, verse 1 to 4. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God, see the same Spirit of God in David's time in Psalm 139, and the same in your life right now. The Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Then God said, let there be light. And there was light, you know, like a torchlight shining in the darkness. And God saw the light, that it was good. See the word good there. And God divided the light from the darkness. So that's how the earth was created. Now, the same with your current situation. No matter how dark it may be at the moment, there's hope for you. The Lord is shining His light into your darkest situation or your darkest past. For some of you, you know it, that recently you have gone through a very challenging time with no light at the end of the tunnel. Fear not, because today God's message for you is He is in the midst of setting you free, releasing His light into your life, because He wants you to move on in your life and keep looking ahead for a greater future till you meet Him again face to face, till Jesus returns. So hang on strong, hang on there. Philippians chapter 1 verse 6 says, being confident of this very thing, that He, God, who has begun a good work in you, will complete it until when? Until the day of Jesus Christ. So may the Lord grant you the strength. May you receive that strength to carry on, to persevere till the day you meet Jesus face to face. Amen. So from now until then, when you meet Jesus face to face, just flow with the Spirit of God. Just be led by the Spirit of God, guided by the Spirit of God. And God will surely know how to lead you step by step. Remember, the steps of a good man or a good woman are appointed by the Lord, ordered by the Lord. Fear not. That's in your Psalm 37, verse 23. So right now, whatever your situation may be, now God is dealing with your past, because God wants to set you free and give you a fresh hope going forward. And even in your current situation, current condition of your life, whatever it may be, the Lord has hope for you. The Lord wants to turn your desert into garden. The Lord wants to cut river in the desert for your life. Now, let God do His part. The Word of God works. So right now, your part is just to receive this. Receive it today and open your heart to the Lord and let the Lord's light shine right into your spirit, even in the deepest most of your life, shine even into the deepest most of your soul. And I want to pray for you right now. Oh Lord God, I thank you for this vision of your torchlight that shines even through the darkest of caves, deepest of caves. Not because you want to find fault with us, but because your heart is a good heart. Your heart is a heart of restoration and hope. Because you want to bring light to any area of our lives that have been affected by hurts, wounds, shame, or failures in our past. And you want to bring fresh hope into our lives till Jesus returns. So Lord, We receive your strength right now. We receive your joy. We receive your peace. We receive your unfailing love. And we receive your hope as we look ahead to the many more things that you have in store for our lives. And all this we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. So people of God, be prepared. God wants to go deeper in your life. God wants to go even more personal with your life. There's nothing to hide from God. You may be hiding things from your friends or people around you, but with God, don't hide. Just let God shine His light. And the more you allow Him to shine His light in your life, the better. Remember this, God will not lead you into trouble. God will always lead you into better things if you allow Him. Amen? So I'll see you again the next time. God bless you. You have a wonderful day.